Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Siege. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here, and there's gonna be some violence. These archers teleporting in to waste us is going to be something that I have a feeling is going to very quickly wear on my nerves. Thankfully, they are fairly squishy, I suppose. Ideally,
it's not going to be a common thing that these things pop in groups like this, but I have a feeling that's the entirety of this area is going to be these things teleporting in groups like this, so
the butt hurt is already beginning to form. Ideally, though, it won't be too bad. Because, I mean, we took that group down without, you know, too much trouble. Okay. This area, I was gonna say, yeah, the camera is not going to like this area, I don't think. I'll just play the whole game top down. Really rather not. Anyways, I don't know, I gotta think of something to tangent about, guys. This is now my tangent Let's Play, where in every new episode, I tangent about something new. Leave a comment below about what you would like me to tangent about in the future. I don't know if I necessarily want to charge too far into this room because more of these guys could spawn. I don't know, even these things are pretty nasty. I mean, they're both doing some damage between them and the archers. Come on, healers. What are you doing, aside from not healing Devon like you should be? Just spam that spell. Naidi has hit level 42 and ranged. Okay, and we got a large kite shield, which may be an upgrade. Plus one to ranged versus 7 health. That is an upgrade. Let's see, what does he have? Can he afford to lose the strength? I don't think he can now. Well, he can, in fact, afford to lose strength. Okay. Well, in that case, what do we have here? 38, that one's 50. So this one's better. But he still can't use that. But you, Gjorn, your inventory is full because reasons. Okay, you can afford to lose some dex. Well, here you go then. Have a new shield. Look at that. Defense for the whole front row. Everybody's at 400 defense now. Devon's almost at 500. He's at 498. 20,000 gold. Because, I mean, I know when I have a large castle, I'm just going to leave tens of thousands of gold pieces sitting in assorted chests throughout my demesne. You know, good choice. Alright, so we've got a pack of these things coming for us from somewhere. That's okay. Oh hey, there they are. Oh, through the door! How novel! I'd have never thought. Thankfully, words are hard. Thankfully, we killed the archers before we took these guys, so we didn't get swarmed or anything. Who are they? Why are you aggroing onto my archer? Like, seriously, dude? What do you got? No reason. There's no reason for that. It's rude. Alright. Well, and another Mokusa Raider. And another Mokusa Raider. They're everywhere. Mokusos for all. And one of them dropped 22,000 gold pieces. Nice. Okay, take that. Where we got spawns. Alright, just one melee. That's acceptable. I'll go down for that ranged user in just a minute. Or he's gonna come to us, apparently. Whatever. I guess if he wants to do that, more power to him. Alright, so let's see what we got here. Well, it's certainly a room. Certainly a room. Let's kill this dude. Man, if only there were some way to import this game's graphical resources for environments and stuff into Neverwinter Nights. There's so much stuff you could work with. Just, wow. You could do some probably pretty incredible stuff. Cloak of Monstrosity. Alright, nobody's ever gonna use that. Hey, let's build a cloak.
It's meant for intelligence users that increases their strength at the cost of their dexterity. Surely, this is the best item for them. Alright, we're gonna focus down on this Sek here, because these Mokuzas, they don't seem to do quite as much damage as the Seks do. I mean, they're doing some damage, but it's not really in the same ballpark. The Seks are much more dangerous. Oh, we got a long crossbow. I think I've been finding those things and they've been nothing but crap the entire time. Oh, seriously? Of course, I had to move just enough to aggro some more of these friggin' archers. Kill that thing, move on this guy. Well, these guys, apparently. Because for every one I engage, two more spawn. Eulora's gonna go down. Yeah, saw that coming. Oh wow, Eulora just got pasted. Unsurprised, I guess. Melees are fighting. They're going strong. Kill the archer. Kill the archer. Kill the archer. Alright, kill this stupid thing that is insistent on attempting to maim my back row. You. Alright, now it's just clean up. I will let them handle this. Because as you can see, these things are, I mean, they're doing, like I said, they're doing some damage, but it's not, you know, an inordinate amount. Alright, everybody's got healing potions, so I'm not particularly worried here. We should be able to chew these things down, you know, pretty handily here. Alright. Mongyorn. Mongyorn, yeah, you outlasted, you badass. Alright. Now, heal the healer, you know, the one that's actually capable of doing your job. There you go. Get him back on his feet so that he can res her stupid ass and go about healing everyone. Pick up all your crap, woman. Ugh. Disappointing! Okay. I saw I suppose I should save, but it's only been 7 minutes, but then I remembered I'm a coward, and so I'm gonna save anyways. Like, yeah, I love me some saves. Okay, so what do we got? Well, that's broken, and it doesn't really even lead anywhere anyways. So I guess we're just gonna take the tower here. Ugh. Nice, you know. That's some structural integrity that thing can just kind of hang off the ledge like that. That's impressive. I love, who is that? Who is just sitting there? Devon, why are you just standing here like a jackass? Because you have healed selected, okay. All right. As per protocol, it's my own stupidity that gets me in trouble here. I shouldn't say stupidity. Inattentiveness is a much better word. Is my inattentiveness that gets me in trouble when my melees elect to just kind of stand there staring at the clouds as opposed to, you know, maiming things with their swords. What are you gonna do? Alright, and these archers are officially boned. Oh, you guys. You so dead. They're dropping mana potions. It seems like mana potions are becoming more and more common. In the beginning of the game, they rarely dropped. Now I'm getting them more than health potions, which is kind of obnoxious. I would rather health potions, I think. But what can I do? Except bitch about it on the internet. And I do apologize for the audio issues last episode. I figured out what the problem was. It was an issue with the volume levels. Oh, there's a mage. There's an issue with the volume levels, obviously. I forgot. Oh my lord. I don't even know what killed him. Okay, both of my casters just died for some reason. No idea. Moderately irritated about it, though. And my archers are back there being completely useless. As per protocol. Okay. Well. Yeah. Let's go ahead and rectify this issue, I guess. Resurrect. And Demis here. God almighty. Nightmare. I don't even know which of their gear is which. Did he seriously just auto-loot. Why are you not... He's just not auto-looting. There you go. That's good enough. Except you have a combat magic spellbook equipped. There you go. Res her. Start healing yourself, and then she can pick up after herself. Oh my frickin' god. Where did those arrows even come from? Oh. Because, I mean, that's fair. Oh my lord, what is this pile of bullshit? No, stand right here. Oh my god. Oh, this is bad. Like, I'm going to have to waddle my ass all the way back down and around because she elected to stand on the edge and get sniped by these guys. Get away from the edge, get away from the edge, get away from the edge, get away from the edge! Oh, alright. Loot all your shit. There you go. Stay away from the edge. No. Look at that. They're arcing their arrows up over the ledge solely to kill her. That's impressive, but it enrages me. Okay. So she has no armor. She does have her spellbook, though. What was she using? I guess I'd say probably this, which she has no room for. Start passing crap out here to free up some inventory space. Okay, so she was not using that because her strength is too low, apparently. Well, she can't use that, and she wasn't using that, so... What was she wearing? Probably this. It was giving her strength to use that. There. Okay. I am still moderately enraged. I'm sure you all can tell by my... This is my angry voice right here. Freaking, I don't know. That was some bullshit right there. I'm like I said, I'm perturbed. All right, let's see what kind of army we're gonna face. Oh my lord! It's because he was standing in there. I'm like, are they getting like ganked in the back row? And no, it's just because, you know, my healer elected to charge forth into melee, probably because I forgot to switch him back to healing magic. Oh my god. This place is going to drive me nuts with these enemies that keep teleporting in. Like, alright, switch over to damn healing spells. Like, this is maddening. Very, very frustrating, because you can't plan for an encounter when you don't know when an encounter is going to be, and you know, I'm okay with the occasional ambush. That's, you know, good game design. You throw the player on their ass every so often. But when it's gonna be like every other encounter, you know, as this place has been designed, bad, just bad. Don't do that. I mean, you can. Then you have people like me that bitch about you on the internet. Ridiculous. Kill these archers. There we go. I really wish that when I tap H for healing potions, that everyone that was injured would drink a healing potion instead of people that are at less than like 50% of their hit points, because sometimes maybe I just want people to drink damn healing potions. Maybe I have to use Shift H or something. I don't know. Shift H? No, Control H? Well, that just did a thing that I didn't know Windows was capable of doing. Apparently Windows H brings up a little sidebar in Windows 10. That's new. I have no idea what I'm ever going to use it for. I don't even know what it says. What does it say? Share a screenshot of Dungeon Siege to Facebook via mail, messaging, OneNote, or Twitter. Oh, well, that's... Okay, then. I'm never going to use that. Go die in a fire, Windows 10. Some of your shit is just... absolutely asinine. No. Yeah, I ain't playing that bullshit. Here, let's have you run the gun. Nope. You dicks are coming to me. I'm making you do the footwork. What is that thing charging after? It doesn't even know what it's going for. It just runs over here and you know, realizes that it's deciding to run into a wall and elects better of its time. Ugh. This game. 20,000 gold. This game is interesting. I don't want to say it's like Titan Quest in that there are areas where, you know, it's a piece of cake and then it gets ridiculously hard. But it's kind of like Titan Quest in that there are areas where it's a piece of cake and then it gets ridiculously hard. Although in this case, it's not hard due to monster difficulty. It's hard because the developers are being dicks and the AI isn't smart enough to keep up with their dickery. Oh, we can apparently see into the, oh, that's outside, okay. It's just the fog of war. I was like, is it the abyss? Is this what lies beyond? Kill this freaking thing eventually here. All right. So these archers, at least the archers are pretty fragile. I mean, they've got 780 hit points, but we carve them up pretty quickly. They don't have nearly the defense rating of the grunts. Oh, I see you coming. Don't think I don't. I'll wait. And he's like, I will ignore you in favor of the dude with the grenade launcher. Because I am an asshole. Come on, Glorin. I know you don't have a ton of hit points, but you're sitting far better than Naidi. Cut down this Mokusa because it's squishy and it'll go down quick. Switch over to the grunt. And these mages, I mean, here, hit somebody with a spell. The mages, I can't even really tell. Like, is that thing dealing? The mage really isn't doing too much. He's just kind of sitting back there throwing sparkles at my melees and they're getting irritated by it. So they're gonna cut his ass down. Yeah, that ended predictably. Just like this is going to. Aw, yeah. Time for the violence! So much violence. And this is an impressive amount. God, get out of my screen. This is an impressive amount of violence, I will say. Okay. How are we looking on potions? Devon needs them. Okay. Take the gold, take the mana, take the amulet. Grab that Yorn. What is the amulet? Amulet of Refuge. 15 health, minus 15 mana. That is okay, I guess. All right, everybody in here so that I can dole out potions. Jesus, I got so much crap. I need a shop so bad. Not for potions, but just because I have so much garbage in my inventory. Here, let's have a look at everybody. Gonna start moving stuff over. I don't want to say this is impossible to keep track of, but this is a pretty expansive amount of garbage to make sure everybody's, you know, running around with the adequate amount of stuff. It's not bad, but for a let's play, I don't, you know, want to have 20 minutes taken up by me fiddling around in inventories, which, were I playing this alone, you know, every time I picked up a piece of gear, I'd be comparing it against everybody's everything just to make sure that, you know, it's not an upgrade or it is an upgrade. Whereas for this, I'm kind of going a little looser. So, it is what it is. Oh, we've got a Punisher. Speaking of a Punisher, man, if you guys haven't watched it, Daredevil on Netflix, holy shit. That is a wall, guys. This is some high action gameplay. We've got some violence going on, but seriously, camera kept trying to screw me. Yeah, the Punisher is great on Netflix. It is really good. And the guy that they got to play the Punisher in season 2 played, oh, I can't remember his name. He was in The Walking Dead. I only saw the first couple seasons of Walking Dead, but he was in The Walking Dead. And honestly, my favorite person that's played the Punisher was the dude that played it in the early 2000s movie. I thought he fit the role perfectly. And the guy that they've got playing it now is not that guy, which makes me sad. However, he's actually pretty damn good as the Punisher. So, yeah, it took a couple episodes for him to grow on me. Like, initially, I thought it was kind of like so-so, but he got there. And yeah, really good show, and it's on Netflix. Season 2 just came out, I don't know the exact date, recently this month. Very good show, very good show.
murder this guy. I just have a feeling that this is luring me into some horrible, horrible thing. So I'm gonna save after we kill this guy. What's that? Oh, a grenade going off. Okay, I thought that was another one of these suckers spawning in. I was just thinking to myself, you know, please no more. Give me a chance to save. All right, so let's go on. Okay, so we can go into these. All right, so it's just going into buildings. And apparently fire in here. What's going on? Oh. Okay, so there's nothing in here by the look of things. I'm gonna rush the archers. Because the Mokusas really are not too much of a threat. As I have mentioned previously, the archers, on the other hand, tend to be slightly more of a threat. Oh, and we've got a warrior. Who's probably going to make himself a pain in my ass. He goes for that mule, so help me God. Why do I have the mule selected? Where's my mule? You sons of bitches! That mule ran into this other room and aggroed everything. Hate, ladies and gentlemen. Hate. I inscribed hate on every nano angstrom of my being. It would not... Yep. It would not equal out to like a trillionth of the hate I feel for that goddamn mule sometime. Jesus Lord. I do enjoy the ring of loot that appears around him when he gets splattered though. I think that shit's funny. Alright, Gjorn, you have healing potions, you're just choosing not to drink for some reason. Here, give my caster some mana pots. There we go. Alright. Okay, everybody's conscious that needs to be conscious, and we'll deal with the mule after. It's freaking ridiculous. Ridiculous. The goddamn duckless. Lauren has increased in his dexterity. I can appreciate that, I guess. I don't know what it's doing for him with that grenade launcher, but hopefully it's something. So, wait. Okay. So, nope. Okay, so casters will drink mana potions at any time, but the rest of my party won't drink health potions at any time. At least be consistent, you dicks. Jesus Christ. I'm raging. My mule died, and the game's inconsistent about how it handles potion drinking. I'm mad, and I'm not gonna take it anymore. Okay. And that's when, like, the episode just cuts out, and there are never any more episodes of this. All because the mule died. Yep. One of these days, guys. One of these days, I'm gonna be a loose cannon like that, and I'm just gonna cancel a Let's Play, you know, 90% through the game just because, I don't know, the shadows didn't look right or something. I'm sure people would appreciate that. Oh, 20,000 gold. Nice. Oh, what is that? Oh, it's an armor stand. Okay. Archkite shield. I honestly do not care. Our inventory is full, and I don't want to deal with more inventory management than I'm already dealing with. And Naidia is advanced to level 44. She has outpaced Gjorn now, I think, officially. Because I want to say she's at a... Well, I think she's at a 42, and he's at probably a 41 base? Or is that 44 before? Oh, 47. Okay, so yeah. She's outpaced him in base skill and is far outpacing him with the gear that she's got equipped. Nice. Yeah, that crossbow, you know, really turned her around. Glorin was quick to level initially, but he kind of lost out there. I'm gonna save as soon as we're here. I don't know, this game's just making me worry. This area is making me worry, just that the enemies could teleport in, seeing, you know, one of these things standing over here and thinking to myself, oh, I could just charge that guy, and when I do, you know, archers. This whole area just turns into archers. That's the kind of shit that I'm worrying about now. Because of crap like that. So let's see how many of these things we end up spawning in my run to kill this one archer. Wow, none. Okay, there's some Punishers, but they've got 860, 880 hit points. Alright, how fragile are they? Where are you? Oh.
These things go down like nothing. Blood and iron. Alright. I wouldn't mind finding a transmutation spell. It would let me turn items into gold. Blood and iron raises strength of the entire party by one. Holy crap, guys. That's totally worth... What was it, a 60 nature magic? Yeah, I'm all over that. You know, super excited. Where is he at that he is... Alright. Apparently he tripped and got unconscious. I don't know. Alright, let's go ahead and murder this thing. A brigandine glove that is possibly cursed, and fire rain. Wow, that was an empty chest. Screw you, game. Frick. Fire rain, level 48. Hail of fire from the sky, burning enemies. 139 to 190 damage. That is a lot of damage, but our combat mage is level 15. Even the one that we found earlier was only, I think, in the late 30s. I think it was 35 or something. It's ridiculous. You don't... Your spells, you're casting it. Even if you are offensive casting, you're not gonna do it enough that you're gonna level quick enough because it costs so much of your mana that you're just never gonna be able to keep up with it. I don't know. I know I said it really early on that I didn't much care for the spell casting in this game, and that still rings very much true. I liked it a lot better in the second game, where they kind of went the way of basically skill trees. It just worked better. It just worked so much better. And you had like the ultimate abilities and stuff that were your, you know, incredibly hyper violent finishers. I really liked that. I think it worked a lot better in the second game than it did here. Now, having been said, the second game's world being, you know, completely linear sucked butt. And there was no awesome multiplayer side quest or anything like this had. We're basically at a completely separate game world for multiplayer. That being said, the second game wasn't a bad action RPG. They added a lot of stuff that made it really interesting. I remember in particular the ability to socket things into items. You could make some just ridiculous items because how the socketing system worked, basically you'd find these ingredients and a given item had so much space in it that you could fit the ingredients into, kind of like the Herodric Cube in Diablo 2. Except imagine that the size of the cube changed based on the item, and you could socket essentially jewels, or not jewels, what were those things you could pick up in Diablo 2? The little things that you'd just sit in your inventory and they'd give you bonuses. I can't remember off the top of my head what they were called. I think it started with a T, I don't remember. Anyways, you could essentially socket those into items, and there were just tons of these things that you could socket into items, into these slots. And it was great. You could really tweak your items a lot, and I really liked that. It added a lot of depth to the game. And I thought it was really cool, and I'm surprised actually no other action RPG has done anything like that, although I'm sure balance-wise, it's just an absolute nightmare. Can you drink mana potion? Oh, a sec grunt. This looks fortuitous. Oh god. Kill these guys. Oh, elevator. Okay. Okay. I was figuring there was going to be something that came out of there and attacked us or whatever. But if it's an elevator, grand. Looks like we're going to be able to finish this fight and then I'm going to call an episode. Oh, it's just unbreakable. Boo. Alright, we got to be getting close. Wait for this thing to come up to save again. And then we'll call it. Alright, so, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time, wherein maybe we fight a dragon. Until then.